Hey everybody, we're at the Nori Point Marina, which is connected right here to the beautiful Hudson River Estuary. And since the Hudson is an estuary, that means it has a direct connection to the ocean. So when the tides rise and fall in the ocean, they also rise and fall here on the Hudson Estuary. It's about high tide right now. Now some months and some weeks the tide may even get a little bit higher, but this is a typical high tide right here. If you follow sea level rise projections, a lot of scientists think that in this part of the Hudson, we might see a sea level rise because of climate change somewhere in the order of 14 to 15 to 16 inches above what it is now by 2060. So I've taken this pole and we've put 15 inches on this pole right here. So this is what we might see as sea level rise between now and 2060. Now, other things also change the level of the water, not just the tides and not just climate change, but also hurricanes. Some people may remember Hurricane Sandy caused a huge storm surge from the Atlantic Ocean to come up New York Harbor into the Hudson River Estuary and actually rose above the high tide about 7 feet. So we had a 7-foot storm surge, which is what I've got between these pink marks. Now think about this for a second. If we have a Hurricane Sandy-like event in 2060, we'll have not just the 7-foot storm surge, but also on top of that, the 15 inches of sea level rise. So a cool activity you can do is go down to your local waterfront and actually examine what a Hurricane Sandy event might look like on top of sea level rise. So, you need a few pieces of equipment. You need a pole or a 2x4, something that's a little bit stiff, something that you can measure off the height you want. In our case, it's the 7-foot storm surge plus the 15 inches of sea level rise projected for 2060. You need a string so you can tie that string at the mark that you want. Oh, shoot. So here it is, sea level rise plus storm surge, and you need a friend.
Hey, Bowser, do you need a friend?
I do need a friend, Maya. Will you be my friend?
I would love to.
Yay! So on the other end of this string, I've got my friend, Maya. Maya, what are you doing?
Bowser, I'm gonna try and hold this string as level as I can from your high level mark to where I am.
All right, I'll keep it steady.
And I'm gonna use a little tool to help me keep it especially level. This here is gonna hang on the string and let me know when I've got it exactly the right height to show the water level as it extends from where you are all the way over to this fine shed here. Here you can see how high the water level would be with a storm Sandy-like event on top of sea level rise. And we're looking at a pretty substantial amount of water here that would not only come into and around this shed, but also lots of other infrastructure around here. The marina, buildings over here, the parking lots, the roads, maybe even railroad tracks, sewage treatment plants, all kinds of things that are gonna be inundated in the future.
Now, stuff like sea level rise, remember, some of this is modeling, some of this is projections, but Hurricane Sandy, that happened. We know that waterfronts have the capability of changing. So thinking about how to better design our waterfronts to be more resilient to climate change and storm surges is a really important part of keeping our Hudson and all of our communities along the river safe and healthy. Thanks.
Thanks, everyone.